Hello everybody, this is Sipidus and we are back with the Kerbal Space Program video game, and I'm really excited about today. This is the start of my International Space Station remake. It's the complete history of the International Space Station. And I've been working really hard to try to get the details right. Not like perfect, not everything about it's perfect. But the visuals of the modules that is being attached to the space station is going to be accurate. The launchers that I'm using are going to be accurate. The launch sites are going to try to be accurate as far as latitude of the on the Earth or on Kerbin. Right now we are sitting, should be, the Baikonur Cosmodrome, which is just north of this beautiful river, which is the Zarya River. And we are going to launch the Zarya rocket, the Zarya module, I should say. And so this is right about where the Baikonur launch site is. We're at site 81. We're at about 45. Well, this is about 45 degrees north latitude. I think Baikonur was 46.0 something, but it's really close. And the International Space Station, it sits at like a 51.6 degree inclination, and that's what I'm going to go for. And although it's like 400 kilometers above the Earth's surface, if I was 400 kilometers above the Kerbin surface, you'd be able to see all of Kerbin from your vantage point. And well, that's just not how it works. To be scaled, because since Kerbin is so much smaller than the Earth, I'd have to be at like a 30,000 kilometer orbit, and you can't do that. You'd still be in the atmosphere. So I'm going to try to aim for like 100 kilometers. That's low Kerbin orbit. So that's what we're going to do. Let's launch this thing. Let's get going. I've been wanting to do this for so long. So I will talk about my ship on the way up. Let's launch this thing. All right. It is November 20th, 1998, and we are making history. This flight is powered by 6 engines. And if you can kind of see how not all of the engines gimbal. So like I have pairs just like that. And that's kind of how like the real Proton-K rocket was. And I do have to pay attention because I do have to perform gravity turns. And I don't want to miss my mark. That's how the real thing engines were. Like they didn't have all the engines gimbaling like on a 6-point axis like this. So what they did is that, you know, they could have, but they didn't. So what they did instead is they had 6 engines around the rocket and they all do this. And so all working together, you know, very sophisticated, you know, type of engine, all working together, they were able to simulate the 6-axis gimbaling. And I try to get like my thrust to weight ratio very similar to the way it was. It's not perfect. It just isn't. But like I reduced this thrust to 97 to try to simulate the same thrust at the beginning of the stage. And then once the tanks are empty, obviously you have a lot more thrust, a lot less weight. And I tried to I tried. And the gimbaling. So like these engines in Kerbal, they're like, you know, they gimbal at like 10 and a half degrees, and that's not the case. It was something like, it was like 3 degrees or something. So I limited it to be scaled down. And we are getting ready for our stage separation soon, and then I can show off the next stage. Let's get a good view. What's a good view? Chase? Yeah, that's a pretty good view. Man, these engines take a long time. Looks like it's empty, but just because of that huge tank in the middle and then these outer tanks are small, it looks... There we go. Now we're out. Let's give it a little bit of weight. And we have stage separation. Excellent. So, oh, we are getting really close. Really close to our... to our orbital apwaps for our ascent. And I'm gonna cut off the engines there. So like it's not exactly the same. Like my launch profile isn't the same, my ascent and everything. The gravity turn doesn't match. Because how can it? This is Kerbal, it's not the same thing. And I'm not perfect. I'm flying this by hand and it's very challenging. So the way the Zarya mission worked was they had like an inclination or an eccentricity of what, like 0.2 or something, a 0.2 eccentricity, I think. I can't. To where it wasn't perfectly circular. And then they used the actual Zarya module, which is inside my casing here, then to circularize and put it at the, I can't remember where it was. It might have been somewhere around 300 or 400 kilometers. I don't know. So that's what I'm going to try to simulate. Even though I don't have the right speeds and everything, I like to try to replicate as much as I can. And since I can control this, I will. All right, and I'm drifting off course slightly. Okay, and we're coming up to our apoapsis height, so I'm going to want to burn once I get there. So what I'm going to do is have my periapsis at about 70 kilometers and my apoapsis at like 90. Yeah, let's go 90 to try to get as big of an eccentricity as I can. 70 obviously is the lowest I can be, because that below that is the atmosphere, and then 100 is my target. That's where I want my ISS to be, at 100. Oh, and I'm not even paying attention to my inclination. I need to bring this down. It needs to be at 51.6, and I'm at 52.6. And I need to point up, because I am coming up to my Apple website. There we go. 51.4. All right, and point prograde-ish. Okay, we have separation, and this is where I turn on my RCS. So now the real Proton-k rocket, in the third stage, it did not have any gimbaling. So this engine, this gimbaling is turned off. The thrust is limited way down, because that's kind of how it was in real life. And what they do have here is Werner thrusters. You see how they're kind of powered on? They have four of those, and that's what they use to gimbal the craft. Okay, how are we looking here? We aren't looking great, but it's still fine. We are on a 51.4. This is good. We are at a pretty correct inclination. And my dog's barking. And we can point. Yep, we can. Okay. Let's lower our thrust down a bit. And how are we doing here? Oh, that is a beautiful orbit. I love those inclination orbits. I do like perfect equatorial orbits. And I don't do enough of these inclination orbits. Okay, so we got to be careful now. So we want to be at 90. About 90 kilometers. There we go. We have a pretty good inclination, and I guess it's a good time to save and jettison. There we go. There she is. That's the beautiful Zarya, which, you know, it's pretty close. All stock parts, like I said. I'm using mods, but the parts are all stock. And she is beautiful. And so now I finally have some better maneuver. My RCS blocks here are exposed, and I can whip this thing around wherever I want. So we have our eccentric orbit that I was hoping to get, and there it is at a 51.5. I can fix that in a bit. So now I just need to circularize and get to the target altitude. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm not sure when they de-staged this, when they got rid of their main engine here, or not their main engine, but their third stage engine. But I'm going to do it now, because I have a periapsis height of under 70,000. That means that this will eventually fall back to Kerbin, and it won't be in the game anymore. I don't have to worry about clutter. So there we go. It is decoupled, and I have enough fuel to get us there. Now, I'm not sure if that's the way it was. I'm not sure if this floats around. Well, it wouldn't. It would have deorbited, just because space isn't a perfect vacuum. There are still atoms and molecules in space. They're just not as dense as in an atmosphere. So eventually, things do fall back to Earth in orbit. It just takes a long time, depending on the size and the altitude. So, anyway, let's coast to a... let's get up to our 90,000 apoweps height, circularize, and then push it back up to 100. I think that's what I want to do. Like, I know they changed the orbit of the International Space Station. It varies. Like, sometimes they want to go farther out, sometimes they go closer in. And I don't know why they do that. But I'm just going to have mine at 100. And if, like, when I'm reading up on my missions, they say, okay, now it performed, you know, an orbital change of this, then I will perform that in this series. But for now, I'm just going to put this in a nice stable 100-kilometer orbit. All right, that's good. Push our orbit out just a bit. And this is what it is. So these are the main engines of the Zarya rocket. And they kind of do look something like that. There's an engine block and it kind of points out like this. It's not directly straight, they're out. And that's what I tried to simulate to the best of my ability. And we are coming up near 100. And I feel like they wouldn't have... Oh, look, that's perfect, 100,000. I feel like they wouldn't have opened up their solar panels. They would not have deployed their solar panels until they were in a stable orbit, right? That's another thing. There's many things that I need to know that I don't, that I'm guessing on. But like while it's flying through space, I don't know. Would that put strain? I don't know. Probably wouldn't be the safest thing to do. Man, this thing whips around. Look at that, how fast it is. It's crazy. Okay, we're almost there. Oh man, we're almost there. It's so exciting. I'm excited. I've been working really hard building this thing to its accuracy, doing my research, being a good student. That's pretty close. That is pretty close. I'm off by just like 300 meters, but it's good. And we are at 51.5. Maybe I will change that up. And I'm at a pretty good spot to do that now. And I think I need to point this way, right? I think I need to point this way. Yeah, down. Yeah, we're changing our inclination very slightly. It's slowly going up. I'm going to park it at 551.6. 57. 58. 59. I'm being so touchy right now. And I don't know why. I don't know why it's got to be perfect. But I feel like it does. Okay, all right, here we go. Let's deploy. How do I do that? I do. Now, like, the real Zarya has antennas everywhere. And there's some bars, structures. So it's not exact, but it's really close. Here we go. Let me just describe some of these parts to you. So there's some external fuel tanks here. I don't know if these were external fuel tanks. They looked like it in the picture, but these definitely were. Even though they're not being used for fuel now. They are external fuel tanks, and they are protected by a micrometeor shield. You have your engine block, and you had some like more engines under here. I mean, some more fuel tanks under here, and they are protected by the shield as well. Right now, I just have some batteries in there. And then you have the RCS block, which I tried to make it look as close as possible. And although there is a lander can in here, that's not, it's just, it's round. I needed a round object and I used it. So what this is made up of, even though I have fuel tanks here, there was no fuel in these. All the fuel was in the external fuel tanks here. This one was, it's a module. People go in it. It's a pressurized vessel. So you could dock with this, go through it and go out the other side. And that's exactly what they do with it. They dock spacecraft with it all the time. I'm not sure which end is designated for what. Like the next mission I send up or close to it is going to be the Zvezda mission. No, not right away. I think Unity attaches to it first, right? Unity goes up with a space shuttle and attaches, I think, to this one. And I think the Zvezda goes here. And then other things go here. So it's going to be really exciting. I don't know everything about it. I don't know the whole history of the ISS yet. But I'm going to learn it, and it's going to be ridiculously challenging. Well, that's going to do it for me. That was such a fun mission, and we are sitting here 100 kilometers above the surface. We have the Zarya module waiting for docking. There's a planned mission ahead. It's going to be an STS-88 mission, which is the space shuttle. It's going to be the space shuttle Endeavor, and it's going to bring up the Unity module, and it's going to dock the Unity module with the Zarya using the Canadarm. Oh. I'm so excited. I don't know if I can do that. I don't know if I'll be able to use that, but we'll try. We'll see if I can figure it out. And then on from there, and we're gonna have so much fun. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope to see everybody in the next video and on. So take care. Bye-bye. This looks like a good time to jettison. What happened? Oh, what was that?